And we're back playing Castlevania. No, sorry, not Castlevania.
Castlevania. Much. Oh yeah. There's a hidden section here.
Okay. See it for a second.
HP max up.
Oh.
MP max up.
Oh.
You know how in like
Castle Moon. There was those little. There was those add-ons.
Yeah, that's what I just picked up. I was thinking with the drawbridge. You know, like in Ocarina of Time.
Oh, yes.
You know how you always used to balance on it? And then if you actually managed to stay on it, there was like a 10 rupee up there or something.
I never knew about that.
I think. Or it might have been in a different game.
No, I didn't know about that in Ocarina of Time, but ooh, I do remember...
I'd forgotten this bit.
I do remember trying to balance on it in Ocarina of Time.
Was that not nice?
That was so nice. Oh. I trying to balance on it in Ocarina of Time, and you're just slowly sliding down.
Yeah.
Oh my god, the candles! Do 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 do.
Did I just get a bat? Yeah, summon bat.
Do do do.
The bat dropped a bat feather.
I thought you said there was not many of these.
Yeah, this is where they endlessly spawn. You know, like Castlevania zombies.
Oh yeah.
Because that's essentially what they are. But with that quest, that's where I went was the closest spot to where the quest is for you to actually get them. Also, when you're in here, you have to deal with the bats. These guys are the big toughs. They also drop some of the best, most useful items in the game. Like the ruby... and stuff for you. Then some of the stuff used to make some of the best items. Oh. Bone throw.
Did you just kill the skeleton and get the skeleton shard?
Yes, pretty much. Get a potion. I think there's a ghost up here. No, it's one of the other ones of these bits. There's a ghost. Monster bird.
Sorry, folks. I've got a bit cold now.
Anyway. Leather chest got. Wait, didn't I?
You already got one.
Yeah, I thought so. Well, I can transform those into a bronze and an iron one, and from there make the best armor in the game. One thing I like with this, in this game with the drops, is that things are capable of dropping more than one item at a time. You know, from their drop list. So like that, like there, I just got Alkahest and Limestone.
Fair enough. Yeah. Sound like Link.
Yeah.
It's gonna get very annoying very quickly.
Oh yeah.
How did you manage to do this for 12 hours?
I had... Ah, that's why it sounds weird. There we go. Apply. That's better.
This is significantly less annoying.
I thought the music was a bit quiet. Of course, I have it turned down because normally when I'm playing, I've got like something like 9-9 or something playing on the other screen.
Oh, yeah.
Level up.
Oh, that's nice decoration. Ooh, it's a red chest.
Yeah.
And the best kind.
500G. And a save room.
So we could have just carried it on and saved here.
Yeah, but then we wouldn't be able to start this episode with that nice, walking into the entrance.
Oh, and the, I guess, yeah, I get you.
Because that only happens once. Oh, yeah. I'm pretty sure there's going to be like a diving... ability soul type thing because.
Yeah, this see? Underwater bit there, yeah.
Exactly.
You're gonna be all Scrooge McDuck in this.
Mm. And up here we have. That's the ghost I was thinking of. I'm sure you recognise that guy's attack pattern from the other one.
Oh yeah, the knights.
Yeah.
They're fucking knights. Not as bad as the knights I always used to. I kept thinking and Curse of the Moon. Like, these are nothing. These are like going down in two charts. Where's the real knights?
Yeah.
We never got the real knights.
Another character from Curse of the Moon we recognise.
Oh, that's the actual.
The old guy.
Oh my god, it's the, it's...
Albert, I think he's called. Alfred, sorry. Alfred.
Yeah, but what we called him Dacca because it
was... Yeah, he looked like Dacca from the, the other old man, I think. Cthulhu. Alfred? A fool of a took. The book.
Was that not the book that give us the ultimate power? The yellow book I pick up.
Maybe
it was though. That was I mean, the way we spun the final boss of that was just beautiful.
Let's just keep it there. And then here comes Johannes.
Okay, Alfred, you were shit, except for you got that one power up in Curse of the Moon.
Yeah. Yes, however, many things are different in this from Curse of the Moon. And he goes.
See, I wish to switch on Netflix. Yes, it's that bucket that's been carried around.
Yeah.
That's probably possessing him.
Mm.
But who am I to say anything? Can I borrow a tissue? Because my nose is like going nuts. Now, if. What? Now, let me see if Figgy comes back. You know, the. I've got what his name was now.
What, Zangetsu?
Yeah, Zangetsu.
Mm-hmm.
What he does?
I'm not saying anything.
Well, the thing is, I've seen the good ending, and I know what happens to Zangetsu.
Yeah. I'll head back to the village and see what she has to say. Yep. Did you just see that?
What?
I thought I saw someone hookshotting up. From there.
No.
When I walked in.
You probably saw the dog jumping.
I don't know. These bats are the annoying ones.
They do with their heads, basically.
Yeah, except the I hate this bug.
What?
See the item drop there?
Yeah.
Okay. Because it hasn't landed on the ground, I can't pick it up. there we go.
Did.
Yeah, when I was stood way far away from it. Okay, I can't get up there
yet,
or up there right now, but our path will loop back on itself.
Okay,
so we go through here. Oh yeah, of course that door below is.
Hey, look,
it's
cannon, including the tail.
Yeah. Potion. Oops. Apparently meant to use one then. Oh well. A gap room, or whatever they're called. Garden of Silence.
What the fuck is that?
What, that?
Yeah.
It's a mocko weed. They drop stuff that's quite useful in the cooking stuff.
Right.
And he drops one of my favourite shards. And those flying pigs drop, surprisingly enough, pork.
Which is very
useful, very useful for cooking. I think they're probably going to fall off again. Oh well. Flying pig!
Oh look, it's a dark nut.
Oh good, he dropped iron. You dropped pork! Yes! Oh yeah. And yep, throw axe, summon frog, or summon toad rather.
Release the toad. Is that an Iron Maiden there?
Yes, it is. And if I walk into it, it hurts. But if I can lure one of these guys into it, come on, there we go. I can get past, get the cute beast beret.
Isn't that what he was looking for? Oh my god, it is. It's yeah. That thing that was like the best thing in the game.
Yeah, you see what I mean though?
Yeah.
That gives a bit more calm, that gives a bit more intelligence, that gives a bit more, one more look.
Okay.
That's just worse generally.
Okay.
And also, look how cool it looks. Don't you want to wear one of those?
No.
Aww. Oh yeah, and also being able to get through that gap means those bugs have started appearing. They don't appear anywhere else. They're what drop poison and also antidotes.
Okay.
Oh yeah, I can summon the pig to attack enemies. They also spawn infinitely.
Oh good.
And they're very annoying.
Yes, I can see that. Hence why you're just going, fuck it, I'll get a gun out.
But
ooh, red chest.
I think they always just have 500 G in. Boom. That's not going to get broken. Oh yeah, if you break a lamp while you don't have full magic,
yep,
it drops all those little roses that gives you magic.
Okay.
Ah, steak.
Steak.
I'll want to eat that now for plus 10 strength permanently.
Yeah, that sounds about good.
Oh yeah, a platform there, which I can get to with that same glitch that I used last time.
Yep,
this it's is also people. Technically possible to get across this gap using that glitch.
Okay.
But both those things are really difficult, and you don't really get anything from them.
Okay.
Okay, that one.
Bet you have to kill a weird worm thing.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, level up!
The weird what?
Worm thing. Looks like a millipede.
It's a plant.
I know, but it looks like a millipede.
Get pork, get. Ah, the speed belt. It's not that good. Less luck for one strength. No thanks.
And not the critical. We want to keep the critical.
Yeah, exactly. Because some things provide bonuses beyond just the stats.
Yeah. Like the fact that you can continually critical hit something. Ooh, I smell a boss battle.
Yes, you'd think so. But this is literally just a room.
Seriously?
Yeah. The only thing I've noticed that's different in this room, right, is watch when I pause. See, See how Miriam's glowing red?
Yep.
That's the only difference in this room. I mean, for all I know, later in the game it might be that you're supposed to come to this room for some big central fight or something. But... ah. Entangled Bone, so it plants Mako Weed on the ground. So basically summon your own one.
What, gold chest?
Yep.
Thumbberg, isn't that one of the more...
This is a rather better weapon. It also looks cool.
Hell yeah, it does.
It's the Soul Reaver! It's a similar design.
Okay.
It just doesn't have the skull at the, on the cross guard. Yeah. Unfortunately, the only way out of that bit where I just where you get the sword is to drop down this gap. Yes.
Uh oh.
Straight arrow.
I know.
This is my favorite shard. Swap you for that.
Okay.
See why I like it so much?
Yeah, it's literally fuck you, fuck you, fuck you.
Yeah, but when you upgrade it with the, you know, the upgrade shard thing in, back at the back at the alchemist in the village, Johannes. Yeah, basically what it does is it increases the amount of arrows shot.
So it's basically like a broad attack, more or less, from like, yeah. Sort of like, fuck you.
So, the level 1, which is what it's at now, I shoot one arrow.
Which still does quite a bit of damage.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my god, you just cheesed the hell out of that guy. Oh, that is funny.
Yeah. But at higher levels, obviously, you shoot more. I've got on the other one. I've got it upgraded. I've got everything upgraded right the way to the top. One of the reasons why it's got a 12-hour playtime.
As if you actually managed to cheat a dark nut to death.
Anyway,
you might want to heal.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I am doing. Get the blunderbuss, get that, and save room. We approach the end game.
Captain, welcome to the end game.
We just came to shake the man at the face. I forgot I'm still handcuffed.
Yeah. Demon dog skin. Oh, I got the Giriman soul, that shard. Yeah. Summon Giriman to attack enemies. And you're there?
Are you not?
Yeah. I should probably think about it. Nip back to the village to stock up on potions. Before I take on the final section.
HP max up, yeah.
Yeah. But. Did not know they dropped those.
What?
The bird dropped a flan. A flan.
I could see why that would happen.
Yeah, but that's one of the flan's one of the items you're supposed to make with the cooking thing.
No, do you know why I could see a bird would have a flan?
Why?
Bird steals flan. Bird steals Greg's. Carries it away.
Oh yeah, apparently there's supposed to be a system of like warp rooms in the full game.
Ooh.
And this is where the village one is. There is that glitch.
Yeah.
You can use that to get into there.
Okay.
Apparently. I just haven't managed it. The closest I've managed, I managed to use it, that glitch, to get stuck in a wall a few times. Okay, so we're back in the village. Let's see what quests we've actually managed to complete in that section.
Yeah, I see what you mean about it being a pain in the ass for, Ooh, two of them.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Yeah, thanks. I got 4 pieces of iron. Yeah, and 3 Savnox. Get a cookery. And you wanted 3 Dullahammers, which are those guys with the flails on the ship.
Oh, okay.
and you'll give me eyeglasses, so sod that. Okay, so let's see what we can...
Let's see what we can...
crack.
Great.
Are you eating properly?
I'm gonna go with no?
Yeah, so you're supposed to... Look at the ingredients list.
Dragon egg, milk and sugar.
Yeah. Oh, I can't actually make anything because I don't have any of the other ingredient stuffs.
Doesn't mean we can't make anything else.
Yeah, let's see.
Craft. So I believe...
Ooh, new crafting rest. New... Oh, Palikas. Yeah.
Well, we've got the steel, so we need steel and obsidian.
Yeah, steel we can buy. I can't actually remember where we get obsidian from. Poison, steel, dull blade, nodachi, sumaru. Yes.
Oh, we got the flame whip's new.
Well, no.
The flame whip from Castlevania 2, because you get a farm whip. You get the farm whip and the flame whip.
We can craft that.
Gun made in the Far East.
Yeah, I've never actually made one of these before. Yes, I will craft one of those. Bunny boots. Hollow point, armor piercing, soft point, critical rounds.
One armor piercing rounds and I'm the first fragment. Is that all it takes?
Yeah. And you know those bugs?
Yeah.
Yeah, they drop poison, mithridate, which is essentially antidote, and amethyst fragments.
So you can just keep killing them too?
Yeah. Oh yeah, should craft these two chest guards. Let's see, craft iron breastplate, craft bronze chestplate, craft brigadier... Oh, balls, I don't have a lion's mane. And I can't buy those. Oh well, craft a high potion, so I can buy them. Yeah, mithridate.
You can make that one.
Yeah, but I don't need them. Only one enemy in the entire demo poisons.
Okay.
It's the bug.
Okay.
So let's go stock up on
potions.
Potions.
Let's go kill a boss.
Well, let's stock up on potions. And annoyingly, you can only carry 5 high potions.
Okay.
And let's get some food ingredient things. Let's see, 3. Oh, no. Sell.
We could sell some shards, but okay.
Oh yeah, what shards do we have to spare?
A lot.
Yeah. But most of these weapons are also quite useless.
Don't sell the gun.
What, the musketoon?
Oh, no, it's a fire.
No, it's the Tanashigma we don't want. We don't want to sell. Base Lord. No, we want the dull blades. I need that for that glitch. Pirate hat, hairband, dollar hammer, country dress, tunic, regular ring. Okay, now then. We were partway through ingredient shopping.
Just remember, we're tired. We're marked on time.
Yeah. There. So I should be able to now go and craft all the food that we're missing.
Yeah, and then we're going to have to quickly hop to it to the boss fight.
Yeah.
And probably get our asses handed to us.
Prepare.
Oh, we can create everything.
Yeah. Oh, no, we need a dragon egg. Need 2 dragon... Oh, we've already got one of those in our inventory. Lemon pie, lemonade, mac and cheese. So, let's see. That's the one we're missing. So we need a dragon egg, pork, flour, and mocha oil.
Okay.
quickly back across.
Are we going to literally be able to do this in 5 minutes?
Oh, yeah. I mean, we might run over by a couple with the boss fight, but it's all good.
Well, I'll pause it for when we go back back to the boss then.
Let's see, what can I sell to get this? Sell some bat feathers. Buy dragon egg.
Yes, because I'm sure in the future, man, you can go to a store and buy some dragon eggs.
But here in 1955, dragon eggs are a little hard to come by. Prepare a pork cutlet.
And I can eat all the food and gain the stats permanently.
Yep. So, actually, I'm curious because I've never actually established this. Does eating food increase your health?
No.
Oh. Well, that one did.
What was that, the flan?
I think so. A classic made by slathering pasta with cheese, but this seems off.
Oh.
Oh well.
So now we've got all the stats we can get.
Yep, so we're saved. Now, and these guys drop melting bones and melting skulls.
Nice. Papyrus would be proud.
Oh yeah.
Okay, that's new.
No, you just didn't see it because I went through the other route that brings me out through this hole here.
Okay.
I forgot to show you, and indeed. Then.
What is that supposed to be, a demon?
I think it's a werewolf that's been impaled on a sword on a statue. Anyway.
Okay, here we go.
Stop right there. I'm Batman.
Let me guess, I can get to.
Yes, Zangetsu. In all his 3D glory. He's really an annoying boss fight.
Oh yeah, you should see him in the freaking, you know, the second quest of bloody the first game.
Yeah.
It took me an hour to beat him. And you thought the first final boss was bad? Oh, no. He's just a bitch.
The first final boss was bad.
Well, anyway, if you thought the first final boss was bad, it's nowhere near as bad as when he takes the final boss. Holy shit, is he hard.
Oh, look, now he's got a fire sword. There we go. One Zangetsu. And...
Aww! And we made it with 2 minutes to spare!
Completion time, hour 23. Thank you to backers.
We made it with 2 minutes to spare. So, as you can guess, we're definitely going to be playing this when it comes out, which won't be too long.
Let me just load up my main one. And I was saying about when you've leveled up the shards.
Yeah.
Obviously, in this one, you'll see I have all the best
everything,
and all my shards can be a level 9.
Fair enough.
Although I suspect the, like it says, grade there.
Yeah.
I think that might be what they mean when they say the power improves when you have more of them.
Yeah.
However, okay. Let me go find just quickly demonstrate this.
Oh shit.
Yeah, I'll just casually slaughter everything in the room.
Okay. you're killing things that even aren't on screen. That's pretty impressive. Yeah. Oh, of course! Oh,
What?
You know, there's power up in the Curse of the Moon.
Mm.
That was, you know, those five rods that she could throw at you.
Oh, yeah. That's what that is.
Yeah.
Okay, let me just quickly attempt this glitch one last time. Bugger. Oh, well. Anyway.
That's the end of the game for now.
Yes.
Wonderful game comes out, which we can't fucking
this
wait for.
This summer, I believe.
This summer. Yep. We will be playing the rest of the game.
Yep, so...
But at some point, we're going to go back to Curse of the Moon and do the good ending, because yeah. I have seen the good ending, and it is...
Good.
I'll lead up to this.
Okay.
Kinda. Well, you don't know what happened to Gensu.
Yeah.
So it's kind of lead up to this, but we'll see. So, mm-hmm. I've been Good Games.
I'm Rewan.
See you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye.